Hello guys, BunnyBop here today, and we are going to be reading the prologue of The Fighter's Book, Ice Alone, Book 1. And this is basically just about Icepaw / Ice Storm becoming a fighter in Storm Clan. By the way, Storm Clan is the renamed version of Fighter Clan because I wanted to find a better name for that. So without further ado, let's get on to this book. The night was silent in the forest. The trees peacefully swayed through the soft breeze of the moonlit sky. It was all quiet, until now. Multiple pairs of eyes blinked from each corner in the shadows, and a battle engulfed. They were rabbits who were in this conflict, shouting, yelling at each other. Battle. A large black rabbit with gray stripes pinned a yellow one to the ground. The black-striped one shouted, Sunshadow! How dare you enter our territory! The three stones belong to Storm Clan! The yellow one glared at him with his emerald-green eyes. After tonight, Nightclaw, this will just be another Shade Clan ground. Nightclaw's blue fire eye shot towards the left of himself. Shade Clan rabbits were targeting him, with the serrated claws extended. Nightclaw looked back at Sunshadow. You may be swift and sly, but you and your fighters do not belong in this territory. Sunshadow's eyes burned with hate. With his rear legs, he kicked Nightclaw off of his slim body. One of the rabbits who were targeting Nightclaw leaped right at him, but an orange rabbit with gallant goldenrod stripes shoved the gray one right to the side. He already knew it was from Shade Clan. The orange-striped rabbit extended his claws, but Sunshadow bit the orange rabbit by the foot. The rabbit screamed as Sunshadow's claws tore across his ear. Nightclaw! Help! Nightclaw gasped. Quickly, he got a hold of Sunshadow and his wounded leg. Sunshadow screamed again in pain and fell over. Nightclaw looked at the orange rabbit. Quick, Thunderstripe! Run! The gray rabbit got back on his four legs and attacked Nightclaw. It lashed his claws across Nightclaw's face and wounded him. Quickly, Nightclaw bit the gray rabbit's leg, and he had lashed his claws right through his ear. It sent it limping back into the shadows of safety. Nightclaw! A voice called his name. It was a rabbit named Red Streak. He was a medium-sized white rabbit with fur lying down from his head to his tail. This battle is useless. There are too many Shade Clan fighters. We can't fight against these impossible odds. Nightclaw shouted, No, Red Streak! Storm Clan will never be defeated! His eyes pulsed with desperation. Storm Clan couldn't lose to them. Red Streak sighed. We will have another chance to avenge this defeat. Red Streak looked to the sky with his glowing yellow eyes. Retreat, Storm Clan! Retreat! Red Streak had screamed that out, and the rabbits from Storm Clan ran to the shadows, back into a remaining part of their territory. Sunshadow tried to chase them, but they were already gone. Nightclaw watched them from the brush as they were leaving. Sunshadow grinned. Shade Clan! Other rabbits joined in. A chorus of victory cries shook the forest. Nightclaw growled and ran off. Back at where the Storm Clan camp was, a large tan rabbit with golden stripes looked up at the moon. A star was on its forehead, indicating it was the clan leader. She sighed and looked down. Dawnstar! A voice called her name. Dawnstar's ears twitched. She looked down. It was a rabbit from her clan. It was Leaf Pelt, a gray rabbit with some light green spots on his forehead and back. How is Thunderstripe? Dawnstar asked. Leaf Pelt sat down. His green eyes were fixed on her. His wounds are severe, Dawnstar, but he is young and strong. With my powers, he will heal quickly. Dawnstar sighed. You are a gifted medicine rabbit, Leaf Pelt. What about the other rabbits? They'll be fine as well, Dawnstar. Leaf Pelt respectfully eyed her. I'm very disappointed about tonight's defeat. Dawnstar looked up at the stars. I mean, Storm Clan has not been beaten since I became leader. Leaf Pelt looked at Dawnstar. Are you asking our ancestors for answers? Dawnstar answered, Maybe. We need more fighters if we are going to pull through this war. Have the spirits talked to you lately? Leaf Pelt looked up at the star as well as Dawnstar. Nope, not in many moons. Suddenly, Leaf Pelt's ears perked upwards. He began trembling. Ice alone will save Storm Clan. Leaf Pelt gasped. It was a message from our ancestors! Dawnstar looked right at Leaf Pelt. What do they say? Leaf Pelt answered, Ice alone will save Storm Clan. Dawnstar was shocked. Ice? But all clans fear ice. Many rabbits have died because of ice. Leaf Pelt sighed. This is the message they decided to share with me. Dawnstar looked down from the stars and eyed a neighborhood. You've never been wrong before, Leaf Pelt. If that is what will help us, then it must be true. And that was Fighters, Ice Alone, Book 1, Prologue. So be sure to stay tuned in for Chapter 1 and 2 of this.